If you like my content, please like and click on the subscribe button. Click on the drop-down and select all to see regular updates.
Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Data Sculptor. Today we are going to solve another interesting SQL question. So this time we'll have a table called combination with columns ID, name and category. So if you see, there are around 6 students and category is nothing but the subject. So science, so Rahul is given ID number 1 and category is science, Sham 2 and maths and each and every student and so on. So if you see here, the output is you have the same name and same category for each and every student. The category is still the same, but the IDs are changed. So if you keenly observe over here, there is a small logic over this. So try to understand what is the logic behind it. Try to crack it on your own, because in interviews, most of them, they'll not explain you what is the logic, but they'll directly ask you to crack the logic and solve it using SQL. So I'm also asking you the same. So just try to crack the logic and solve it on your own in SQL. So if you are stuck anywhere, or if you're not able to understand how to crack this logic and how to solve this using SQL, watch this video till the end. So you'll get more clarity on this. So now let's go back to SQL Server Studio and see how to solve this using SQL. And if you're watching our videos for the first time, make sure you click on the subscribe button. So now let's try to understand what is the logic behind this. So if you see, observe it carefully, the input here, all the students are randomly provided an ID, irrespective of anything. So Rahul is provided 1, Sham is provided 2, Peter is provided 3. So irrespective of anything, they are just provided some random IDs. But if you see the output, the first student, the ID 1 is assigned to Sham, and ID 2 and 3, John and Rahul, and 4, 5, 6 to Peter, Ravi and Sham. Okay. So here I think Sham has two names, two subjects. So here it is coming multiple times. But here, if you see, the logic here is the number of students, or the number of students under each category. So if you see, for maths, there is only one student, and for science, there are 2, and for social, there are 3. Okay. So the rank should be provided in such a way that for each and every category, the lowest number of students should be provided the first IDs, and the second lowest should be provided the consecutive IDs, and then the so on. Since the students, since under max there is only one student, which is the least, that's why Sham is provided ID 1. And in science there are 2 students, which is 2 students. So science is having more students than maths and less students than social. So science, so the students for under science are provided IDs after maths. But here John and Rahul are there. So here we are, the names are being, the IDs are provided to students based on the names in ascending order. And social is having 3 students. So Peter, Ravi and Sham, since social is having the highest number of students, they'll be getting the last set of IDs. So Peter, Ravi and Sham, since the names are in ascending order, so 4, 5, 6 are allotted accordingly. So now let's try to write the query and understand how to get this. Since the entire logic is based on the count of students under each category, so let's write a query to get the count of each students under each category. Select star from dbo.combination. Okay. And here I'll write count of 1 over partition by category. So what will this give? I'll just write cnt. Okay. So what will this give? It will give me the total count of each students under each category. So for maths you have only one student, so count is 1, and for science you have 2 students, count is 2, and social you have 3 students and count is 3. Okay. So you can also write in a different way. So like first you can try to write it in a different way, like select category comma count of 1 from dbo.combination group by category. This also you can do, and you can keep this in a CT. For each and every category you'll get a count, and you keep this in a CT with CT as. Okay. And this select from dbo.combination C, inner joint, CTE, B on C dot category is equal to B dot category. And here if you can write C dot star comma B dot count. So this will also give you, this will also give you the same output. So what if you run these two queries together, both will give you the same output. Okay, it's just that we can write, you can simply write this in a single statement instead of writing multiple CTEs and all. I mean, it's not necessary that you can go in the this way, but just for making the query smaller, I'm just using this. Okay, so now what I'll do, I'll just copy this and paste it over here. So now I'll keep this in a CTE with CTE as. Okay, so now we have got, for each and every category we have the total number of student counts. Okay, so select from CTE, select star from CTE. So this will give you the total number of student count. So this is the output. So now what we'll do, we'll simply write a row number function. So row number over simply order by cnt comma name. Okay, as say, keep, let's keep this as rn. Okay, so now if you execute this query, what are you getting? So if you see here, Sham is getting rn1, John and Rahul are getting rn2 and 3, and Peter, Ravi and Sham for social are getting 4, 5, 6. Okay, but these all columns are not required. So what we'll do, we'll just simply keep this rn as id comma name comma category. Okay, so because these are the columns we want. So if you run this query, what are the output you are getting? Okay, just this one. So if you run, let's match it with the output. So Sham match, here is getting ID 1, John and Rahul 2 and 3, Peter, Ravi and Sham 4, 5, 6. So in this way, we need to write this query to change the IDs. So here the main point, tricky point is to understand the logic, or what is the logic behind it. So once you are able to crack this, solving, writing the query is very easy. So hope you all like this question and also the solution and my explanation. So if you like it, make sure you click on the like button. And if you have any questions or if you have a better solution, make sure you comment it. And if you're impressed by this video, please share it to your circle so that more people will watch these videos. And please subscribe to my videos. Thank you. Have a nice day.